Hi friends, today we are going to discuss a topic called roads and bridges for the exam, public works department exam. Okay, so first of all, we are going to discuss how the highway developed in India. What is the development taken place in India in highways? Okay, so this is the highway development chronological order in India. We are going to discuss. First of all, Romans are pioneer in road construction. If you are looking into the history, so the first road was built in Rome, and in today also Romans are having very advanced and wide roads. They are also having a junction where 29 roads meet. That is the largest junction in the world. So the Romans are, from the ancient time itself, Romans are very developed in terms of road construction. In India, if you see, you might have heard the term GT road in every district, in every location. Generally, we hear a name, the old road of that district named as a GT road. That is Grand Trunk Road, which was the first road which was developed by the British government in India. So, coming to the type of construction of the highway. So, if you are looking at the road construction pattern, there are four basic patterns followed from the past, ancient time. So, first one is, these are the names of the scientists. So, this is a chronological order. That means, chronological order means from the past to the present. Okay. So this is the first type of construction, second type of construction, and the third type of construction, and the fourth type of, the latest type of construction. So these are the scientist names who has proposed a particular pattern of construction of a road. So this pattern is needed. In examination, they may ask you, what is the order of the pattern? So the first pattern is Truscott, Metcalfe, Telford, and Macadam. See, all the first three have no engineering importance, but the Macadam construction is the first construction in which we have used some kind of engineering technology. That means providing the camber, providing proper drainage to the road. All these factors were considered in Macadam construction. Earlier, in the first three constructions, they just made a path out of rock, out of soil. So likewise, for using different materials, they have prepared a road without any proper gradient, without any proper curvatures and all. So these are all not scientific methodology of construction. The first scientific method of construction is made by Macadam construction. So from here onwards, we had thought scientifically for the development of the road. So these are the important milestones in the highway development in India. See, these chronological order as well as the years are a little important for a PWD exams. So first, our development has been started by the Britishers only. The first one is the formation of Jaikar Committee. So this was happened in the year of 1927 in British India. They have formed a committee called Jaikar Committee to look after the development of roads and highways in India. So this Jaikar Committee, in their first meeting, they have decided to establish a central road fund, which is the tax they collect on the petrol. So if you are looking at the cost of the petrol, so there is some amount of in the cost of the petrol which goes to Central Road Fund as CRF. This was first initiated in the year of 1929. So first the Jaikar Committee was formed in 1927, and the first Central Road Fund was collected in the year 1929, which was a tax levied on petrol for the purpose of development of roads in India. And next is formation of Indian Road Congress in 1934. So this the intention of creating this Indian Road Congress is to regularize and make some uniformity in the construction of road. As India is very vast country, So you need to bring some normalization of the construction of the roads. You need to keep some methodologies. You need to keep fix some codal provisions in order to maintain the uniformity of the construction in the road. So that is the main motto why they have formed the Indian Road Congress in the year of 1934. Next is implementation of Motor Vehicle Act. So apart from collecting taxes from the patron, they also started collecting taxes from the vehicle insurance, vehicle tax, lifetime tax, what are the taxes which we pay. So all those comes under Motor Vehicle Act. So this was another act which also collects some money from the vehicles. That is nothing but Motor Vehicle Act, which was started in 1939. And after that, for doing some development activities for solving the contemporary issues during the construction of roads, they have formed a research institute in Delhi, CRRI, in the year of 1950. In the year of 1950, they have established a Central Road Research Institute. See, all these things are very, very important for PWD exams, the year and the what is the name and the location. So it was established in where? New Delhi. So it was established in Delhi, okay, in the year of 1950. And then they have brought another act for exclusively classify some part of roads which are having greater importance. So those roads are maintained and constructed as per the National Highways Act, which are the main roads of the India. Okay, so this act was started in 1956, and then formation of National Highway Authority of India. So NHAI was formed to control and maintain the national highways. To control and maintain the national highways, they have created NHAI, okay, National Highways. Now, after that, they have formed a National Highway Development Program, NHDP, to develop roads in India. So what is the program intentions that is important for the examination purposes? So what is the projects that are being undertaken under the program of National Highway Development Program? These are three major projects they have undertaken. One is Golden Quadrilateral, which connects Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai and Mumbai road. So this is nothing but a quadrilateral. So where is the Delhi in the north, Kolkata in the east, Chennai in the south and the Mumbai in the west. So this is nothing but the Golden Quadrilateral. This is nothing but Golden Quadrilateral, Delhi, Kolkata, Chennai and Mumbai. So this was called Golden Quadrilateral, which was already completed. North-South Corridor. North-South Corridor starts from Srinagar in Jammu Kashmir and the Tamil Nadu. Kanyakumari in Tamil Nadu. So this was also another project to connect North and South Corridor. North and South Corridor, Srinagar to Kanyakumari. Srinagar to Kanyakumari. This was another project under NHDP program. And East-West Corridor. East-West Corridor is to connect Silchar in Assam to Porbandar in Gujarat. Silchar in Assam to Porbandar in Gujarat. So this was another project. This was another project which were taken under NHDP program. Next is, before this NHDP, there were, at the beginning of the road development in India, there were road plans. There were road plans, very, very important for examination. There were road plans. So the first one is Nagpur Road Plan. So Nagpur Road Plan was started in the year of 1943. These are all 20-year plans. These are all 20-year road plans. These are all 20-year road plans. 20-year road plans. So first one is Nagpur Road Plan. First one is Nagpur Road Plan, which was started in the year of 1943 and projected to complete in the year of 1963. Here, actually, the Nagpur Road Plan was completed ahead of schedule. So that is the Bombay Road Plan was started in the year of 1961 to 1981. And the third road plan was Lucknow Road Plan, which started from 1981 to 2001. And the proposed pattern of roads in the Nagpur Road Plan was star and grid pattern. Either you need to go for a grid pattern, wherever it is, there is possibility, you need to construct like a grid, or else you need to construct like a star, radial roads, wherever which is possible for us. So likewise, we have constructed the roads either in grid pattern or in star pattern in Nagpur Road Plan, which was also a previous bit in Public Works Department exam. Now, next one is highway economy. So what is the purpose of knowing about the highway economy? See, whenever you are constructing a project, highway project needs a lot of financial investment into it. So some lakhs of crores of rupees are needed for construction of a highway in India. So it is very, very important to run economical models and analyze the optimistic model for the sake of investment in the road development. So for making the minimum cost of the project, economic analysis you need to do by doing some comparative study. That means, see, you need to understand whether the expansion is cheaper or new formation is cheaper. If it is expansion is cheaper, you need to propose different alignments. And what is the cost of the project in different alignments. So, and what is the maintenance cost also. Cost is nothing but not only execution cost. Once you execute the road, after execution, you need to maintain the road. And that should offer a smooth riding surface for the vehicles. Otherwise, if it is not providing a smooth surface for riding of vehicles, the vehicles will damage quickly. So the road usage will decrease. If the road is very smooth, if the road is very effective, then more vehicles will come onto the road and more trips they will make. If the road is not properly made, then what happens? People will avoid to use that road, makes the road unworthy. Okay, it will not create the revenue. Once you invest the revenue, you need to get back the revenue only when you use the road. So that is why you need to understand which alignment will have minimum cost of construction, which alignment will have minimum cost of maintenance, and which alignment will give the smooth riding surface such that the road is utilized by maximum number of people, maximum number of times. So this is the main motto while fixing the alignment of any road project. So for that fixing of alignment, you need to do the comparative study among all these three parameters which I have told you right now. What are the three parameters? First one is construction cost. A comparative study you need to make between construction cost and maintenance cost. Maintenance cost and smooth riding surface. It should ensure a smooth riding surface. So all these three are very, very important for the road to create proper revenue. Okay. So an economical highway should fulfill the following benefits. So incorporating all these three parameters into consideration, we have created what are the benefits that an economical highway will provide. So there are two kinds of benefits. which are direct or primary benefits and indirect and secondary benefits. See, the primary benefits is reduction of operation cost of vehicles. I have told you just now, when the road surface is too smooth, so the vehicle damage will decreases. So the vehicle operation cost will also decrease. Okay. So because of which more number of rides you can have. So in that way, the revenue of the transportation and also taxes, because more vehicles you will purchase, the people in that area will purchase because they can make more number of turns because of smooth riding surface. So more vehicles, purchase of vehicle increases, transportation costs, transportation revenue increases. So it saves the travel time. It saves the travel time, more number of trips a single vehicle can make. So it also reduces the accidents and increases the land value adjacent to the road, and also creates employment because of the road, proper road. See, whenever you see the development always happens along the roads, isn't it? We all know this. So a economical highway should fulfill, an ideal highway should fulfill all the primary and direct benefits. And what are the indirect or secondary benefits which we haven't designed the road for, but they are the bonus for us. So it increases the travel comfort and more goods can reach, whatever the consumer goods can reach to the remote locations also because of the better roads, better connectivity. And whenever there is emergency, these days we all aware what are the issues happening in the border. Just because of the construction of the road only, the dispute has begun. You can understand how important is a road in borders. So this is why always you need to think the road economy, highway economy is not only reducing the cost of the project. It is along with reduction of the cost of the project. At the same time, you must ensure you must provide a quality out product, the quality output for the usage also. Otherwise, if you reduce the cost, it does not indicate that you have economized the road work. You have economized the road work when you reduce the construction cost without compromising the quality of the riding surface. Am I clear to everyone? So this is highway economy. And for understanding this highway economy, we generally study this highway economy using some kind of models, economy models that we will discuss in detail later. So I would like to show you a question in the previous PWD examination. Whatever we have discussed so far, this was one of the questions. We will discuss some more questions in the next session. So this is first question which was came in the previous PWD exam. That one is Nagpur load plan has recommended the use of road pattern time. See, we have just discussed it now. It has indicated to go with star and grid pattern. The option is C or third option. The option is 3. Okay. So you will get similar kind of concepts and similar kind of questions in the sessions, in our live sessions also. Please do enroll for this course. Okay. Thank you so much.